Hello all, this is Naveen. So, Agriculture Scientist Recruitment Board, Department of Agricultural Research and Education, Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, has posted a notification recruitment on the date 19th of July 2021. And it is, I have already told in the previous video, but I missed the education qualifications and other important criteria like age limit and all. So that's why I have posted this video for some of the important information that I missed in the previous video. So watch this video till end to get all the updates regarding to get all the knowledge regarding the examination. Also subscribe to the channel and enable the bell icon if you are a new member who is watching this video. Okay, so the Agriculture Scientist Recruitment Board (ASRB) will conduct competitive exam for recruitment to the post of AO and FNAO in pay level 10th of 7th CPC pay matrix. I have told all these things, so there is nothing much to explain in this again and again. If you haven't watched the previous video, just watch the previous video, you will get it. The important dates for the examination: submission of online application dates, everything I have explained in the previous video. The number of vacancies too, I have explained in the previous video, so I will be giving you a quick chance to look into your category and the total number of posts available in both these examinations, AO, FNAO. Okay, hope you have noted it down. So let's go to the next section, the essential education qualifications, which I have missed in the previous video. For administrative officer, AO candidates must be a graduate of any recognized university, securing not less than 55% mark in the final degree examination or equivalent, and must have working knowledge of computer. Knowledge of computer is necessary. For finance and accounts officer, the same eligibility condition, but there is a desirable qualification. If this is desirable, this is only desirable, it is not compulsory. For departmental candidates, that is the candidates who are working there, you can read this section. I am not planning to waste time on this because there will be only a few candidates who may be watching this video regarding the people who are working in the department. So let's go to the next one, the centers. The centers of the examination is a computer-based examination. It's a tier 1 examination. It's available on Annexure 1, explained the availability of centers and all. That all we will see in the upcoming part. The age limit, the other important thing I missed to update is the age limit for appearing the examination. Candidate must have a minimum of 21 years age and a maximum of 30 years age. This is the important criteria as on the date of 23rd 8 2021, which is very important. And what is this date? This is the closing date of the application. Okay, so there is other important thing you have to look into, the maximum age limit for councils, regular employees holding the post in administrative ministerial category will be relaxable up to 45 years. Not the usual candidates, if you are working there, there is 45 years age relaxation. The upper age limit relaxation is still available for the SC or ST candidates. There is a relaxation of 5 years and up to a maximum of 3 years for OBC candidates who are eligible for the reservation of the OBC reserve to them. For candidates with PWD, SC, ST and OBC, that is PWD candidates with SC and ST or OBC, there is a maximum of 10 years relaxation. Hope you are getting it. So coming to the next other important thing is regarding the examination fee, which is very important, but I failed to explain in the previous video. Let's see in the category. Hope you all came to understand about it. General OBC and EWS candidate, that is examination fees is 480 with a registration fee of 20, amounting to a total of 500 rupees. Then coming to the women or scheduled caste or scheduled tribe or PWBD candidates, there is no examination fees. And the only a registration fee of rupees 20 is there, amounting to a total of 20 rupees only. Coming to the next one, for finance and accounts officer post, you can see the same way, the post, the fees is same as that of the AO. 480 and 20, amounting to a 500 for UR, OBC and EWS. Women, SC, ST, PWBD, it is nil, only registration fees of 20. So there will be comments coming in, sir, can we apply for both the posts? That is 100% sure. you can apply for both AO and F&AO post. Okay, so how you are going to apply? If you are applying, if you are in this category, you must pay a fees of 960 with a registration fee of 40, amounting to a total of 1000 rupees. Women, SC, ST, tribe or PWBD candidates, there are no examination fee, there is only registration fee, amounting to a total of 40 rupees. Hope you are clear with it. Coming to other important thing, this is the thing I have explained is written here in bold. There is nothing much to read in about it. So this is note 1, note 2, note 3, that's all regarding the fee payment and all. So what advice I have to say from here, it is don't go for the last minute rush. You people must never go to the last minute. Apply in the beginning or by the mid time of this opened portal. Pay the fees, apply all the fill up all the forms and do all other thing, okay? So these are the important dates by which the application portal will be, the portal will be opened and closed. Then plan of examination, the scheme and syllabus of the examination. I will make a special video on that later, the detailed syllabus and how to prepare, etc. So don't worry about that. Subscribe to the channel and enable the bell icon so that you will get notification of the videos when I upload. So I will make a video on that, don't worry about it. Then regarding how to apply, you can apply on this official website. Go to the official website, click on the apply section. You will be able to register for the examination. So that's all the important thing here. Let's look into some of the any other important details. So regarding, so these all are the candidates required, the relevant documents that you must provide at the time. On registration, on the final interview, etc. So these are some of the important things that is similar to the other examination also. Keep original ID card in your examination, not the photostat photocopy. You have to keep the original ID during the examination. Okay, then what's other important thing? Then regarding the scanned photograph and all they are speaking about, then other important instructions. These are all are like the other examinations. There is nothing much different from here. Then these all are the important details that are necessary for a candidate's registration and in future. So you must keep these things ready and corrected. If there is any error you have in your certificates or anything like that. Then regarding the examination centers for the examination and all. So guys, if you want to look deep into this notification, I have explained almost all the important thing. If you want to look into deep, you can go to the icar.com, and you will be going to the what's new section, and you can see the notification of AO and F&AO there. So that's only, and you can download this notification. So that's all. So go to icar.com if you want to have more about it. So that's all. Thank you. Regarding the syllabus and all, I will be updating later. Okay, thank you.